Tube manufacturing begins with the production of the steel. In this simplification of the process, the manufacturer melts iron ore and other alloys to meet customer and ASTM specifications. The molten mixture is then poured into a chute where the mixture cools and forms into a thick slab. The steel slab is then fed into the hot rolling mill, where each pass reduces the thickness until it meets the customer specifications. Once the slab is flattened, the steel is wound into a flat rolled sheet coil. In the next step, the sheet coil is fed into the slitter, where it is cut into the desired widths to produce the tube the customer has ordered. These coils are then banded up and shipped to a tube mill. At Webco's tube mill, the coils are inspected and loaded one at a time onto an uncoiler. The uncoiler feeds the strip into the mill, where the ends are welded together. This weld is called an end weld and is scrapped after it passes through the mill. As the flat strip is fed into the mill, the edges are trimmed to prepare the strip edge for the welding process. Strip edge condition and width are critical to the welding process. At Webco's forming mill, a series of breakdown passes gradually form the flat strip into a U shape. Several fin passes round the strip into an open-ended tube, preparing it for the next step in the process, the high-frequency welder. At the weld box, Webco's high-frequency welder heats the edges of the strip. The strip edges are then forged together, resulting in a uniformly welded structure that is extremely durable. After the tube has been welded, it passes through several sizing stands, where the OD is reduced by several thousands of an inch at a time until it meets the customer's requirements. Tubes are then tested using a variety of destructive and non-destructive testing methods. Each method ensures that the tubes meet customer and ASTM specifications. Those that do not meet standards are scrapped. Material that is specified as welded is packed directly off of Webco's mill. All of the material goes through an annealing process. At Webco's weld mill department, the furnace heats the tubes to 1700 degrees, which relieves stresses in and normalizes the grain structure of the steel. Once the tubes are heated to 1700 degrees, they pass through a cooling zone where they are air-cooled before further processing. Material that requires tighter tolerances than the weld mill can produce are transferred to Webco's cold draw department. All others tubing is moved to the finishing department.